when Eugenie Bouchard was in, and I know that you interviewed her on Sportsnet, 590.
Yeah.
I wanted to talk to you about her career, because she is, of all the tennis stars, and no disrespect to Milos and Dennis, but she's the one that's really kind of gained the worldwide stage on a, you know, she's like an on a, like an A-lister, right?
Yeah.
She's had really great moments, and she's had really tough moments, and it seems like she's in a really tough spell right now. What's your thoughts on her career? Are the rumors about her spending too much time doing promo true? Is it that she's streaky? Is it what's Eugenie Bouchard's background and what's her deal?
Yeah, it's a good question. So 2014 was her massive breakthrough, and everyone thought this girl's going to be the best in the world pretty soon.
Seemed like a trajectory.
Yeah, yeah, and the reason she was doing so well was because she hits the ball early, so that's why her stroke's so fast. She's really, really aggressive, and all that's based on her confidence. So she was just going on this roll. No one was used to playing her, and it was working up until the Wimbledon final. That's kind of when the decline started against Kvitova, who's a really hard hitter, and Jeannie didn't really change or adapt her game. And then I think, I would guess, and I don't know because I'm not in Jeannie's head, but I think after that, when you have that level of attention and fame at a young age, it can kind of get to you and the pressure will get to you. But now, years removed, I disagree with the notion that she's not working hard. And a lot of people too, I was talking about this with Jesse before we came on, people read into how her social media is and all that, which I don't think is entirely fair.
She's got a manager for that, right? Like, not posting them.
Well, and the thing too is, I mean, sure, if you're struggling, it's best to keep other people's focus on tennis. But from people who've played with her for the Canadian Fed Cup team and other people in tennis, they say she's a really hard worker and trainer. But that being said, what they say is that she hasn't really changed how she's working, which is sometimes even Milos has said is his fault, where it's the idea, if I train really hard, then I'm going to be better and beat people. But everyone's training really hard, and you need to work smarter, not harder. Mm-hmm. So she hasn't adjusted things in her game. She's still going for the early ball and trying to be aggressive. But if you're playing against people who can counter that, you're not going to get far. So that, to me, has kind of been her issue, is she hasn't adapted. And people I've spoken to, too, in tennis, that's what they see. So now the issue is, and she hasn't been able to, she hasn't stayed healthy this year, which doesn't help either because you can't go on streaks. Mm-hmm. But the issue now with her ranking is she's getting to a point where, I mean, Rogers Cup, she was a wild card. She wouldn't have gotten in because of her ranking. So she's getting to the point where she won't get direct entry into these top tournaments. So is she going to go and play challenger events, which are the lesser known tournaments that aren't as glamorous? Mm-hmm. That's where I wonder where it's going to go.
Now, I know there was a coaching issue as well.
Like, oh, she's gone through a bunch of coaches.
And that's a problem,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, because then you have no clear direction. And maybe she doesn't agree with what they think she should change or what she can do. I mean, she needs consistency. Hmm. Yeah.
What do you think it is with people in Jeannie? Because I'm going through the list of athletes in my head who I've heard, oh, they do too much promo. Or like they do, you know, too many, I don't know, I guess sponsor things. There's PK, for sure, in hockey.
Ronda he gets Rousey, ostracized, right? PK.
He gets ostracized. Ronda Rousey got that in the UFC. Mm-hmm. You know, no credit to Holly Holm. Just, she was doing...
Right.
She's off doing way too much promo. Not the women's division.
Sorry,
has gotten
Holly
so much
Holm
better.
Trained her ass off for that fight.
Yeah.
And
she's
life.
Been braining people in the head with her legs for her entire life. And weirdly, she did that again. And Jeannie.
Yeah.
What is it with her? Because I can't put my finger on it, but when I look at how people talk about her on Twitter, it's weird.
Yeah.
Like, not it's athlete
and
gets this.
And people in the industry, too.
Yes.
Like, it's vicious.
It's super weird.
Journalists,
really?
Well,
and even... And I'm just to throw it out there. Is it because she's beautiful looking?
Yeah. I honestly think there's some sexism with it. Now, she likes attention and has always sought attention and also been very confident in what she says. She's not afraid to speak her mind, which can, of course, get people to disagree with her and judge her a little bit more.
With
Sharapova and all that. But what bugs me, like at the Rogers Cup, she mentioned how playing for Canada can be a burden. Now, that's not smart to say, whether you think it or not. She should know better. I mean, don't point the finger on the media, but I also get where she doesn't feel she's been treated well by the media. But what bothered me after that was there were articles saying that she's just another pretty face on the women's tour. And I'm thinking, if Milosh or anyone else kind of fell back, I mean, she's still a top 100 player. Would you say so-and-so is just a pretty face? Are you saying that about other female tennis, you know, stuff like that bugs me, because then that's where it's not about the tennis anymore. No.
The best athletes in all sports do the most promo. Like, this isn't strange.
Yeah.
That's why she's marketable. I mean, when people say she's marketable, that's what they're talking about.
John Tavares endorses Vita Coco, coconut water.
Coconut water. Yeah.
Like, what is it, Sidney Crosby and Dempster's?
Yeah, Americans don't believe me. Sidney Crosby is sponsored by bread in Canada. Do you understand?
That's so Canadian.
Bread. You can get Sidney Crosby. Well, you used to be able to get Sidney Crosby hockey cards in bread.
Yeah.
He's huge. But no one says Sidney Crosby's doing too much promo.
No, and when
but he's also doing really well.
Right, but when
so it's
Ovechkin
only when they're doing well.
When Ovechkin was struggling, it was never about how Ovechkin looked. It was always
That's
Ovechkin.
What I mean.
Well, maybe his career is going down the toilet, and he's like laughing at them, like, I'm going to score 50 goals on you right now.
Right.
But
because people compare Jeannie to Kournikova, and people say Kournikova didn't do anything. She was just a pretty face. That's what people say.
In the world.
Thank you. It's you know what I mean? You're not saying this about other players. You're saying this about the ones that get the most attention, and a lot of that attention's based on their looks, which just is messed up. But that's just how it is in professional sports, in a large part for women. That's
How's
just
that been
unfortunately
for you?
How it is. In our business,
mm-hmm.
It bothers me, because I think, I mean, television is, it is vain in a way where it does matter how we look and how we're dressed and how we present ourselves. So for me, it's always been, I don't want that to be the focus. I want to be a good broadcaster, and I don't want to bring any more attention to things that I can't control, which is my appearance. Because you get things on Twitter, nice or not nice, but to me, it's, I don't know you, so that's not, that, well, but you know what I mean? That's not going to affect my confidence.